2, 3 Action. Yeah, what's up guys? Fahan here with Zah once again, and today we have Asri. How are you, Asri?
Good,
thank
I'm
you so much for coming out. Actually, your friend Danny was the one that asked you to come, right?
Yes. Against my will. Yes.
Against your will, alamak. So never mind lah.
So are you comfortable being in front of the camera?
And sharing about your bike?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You're okay, alright lah.
So anyway, Danny's friend, he actually rode the BMW
F800.
F800. That video will come out after this lah. Mm-hmm. Sorry, your friend asked you to come.
Okay. He sabo okay, you. He sabo you.
Sabo rabak.
Okay, so this is Asri's bike. A CB1000, is it?
CB1100.
CB1100, 2013 model.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And wow, it looks like a retro.
Retro inspired modern, yeah?
Yes.
It is very beautiful bike, you know. I just love this naked classic look. It just gives the person a sense of raw power. Because it doesn't have any like cover fairings. It's just like an engine with a body frame, and it just looks raw.
So Asri actually tells us a story about his bike. We're going to give a bit of background about it.
Introduced in 2010 as a modern spiritual successor to the original CB750, the Honda CB1100 is styled as a universal Japanese motorcycle. In 2017, further modernization was added to the CB1100 with LED lighting, a new lighter exhaust, supercarch, and a 6-speed manual transmission. Asri's bike is a 2013 model. Engine is a 1140cc liquid-cooled 4-stroke 16-valve DOHC inline-4 with fuel injection and a 5-speed constant meshed manual transmission. In Singapore, the CB1100 is an uncommon bike given that it caters to a niche market of riders.
Okay,
so brother Asri, how long have you rode the CB1100, and why did you get the CB1100 as your bike?
About 2 years. I've been riding this bike for 2 years. The reason why I got this bike is because I actually am into the old look, but I don't want the old problems. Coming from a bike that I got previously, which was a Kawasaki Zephyr 750. That was a 1993 model. So I had a problem with that bike. It's now in heaven. in Alila. Yeah. So I decided to get something more stable for once. So I went to research and I found this bike on Carousell. It was at a good price. So I went ahead to buy this one.
How much was it selling for?
I got this for $13,000.
How many years was it?
About 5 years left.
5 years left. So you're the second owner, I assume?
I am the third owner, actually.
Third owner.
Yes.
To be frank with you, the CB1100, I have never really seen it before.
Okay, because for the CB1100, it's normally parallel imported. So if you go Bunsiu, the Honda dealer, you most likely can't find this model. You will have to get from another shop instead. So normally for the new, this bike is still ongoing production. This is the 2013 model, which comes with 5 gears only, whereas 2014 onwards it comes with 6 gears. And they have another model, the RS model, which comes with the dual exhaust. For this one it's only the single exhaust.
But the outlook really looks like as if it's from the 1970s.
really beefy.
It is inspired from the old CB750, which was during the 70s period.
Does it come with modern features like ABS, traction control and all that?
It has ABS, has traction control, I think. Traction control, not sure about that.
I don't think so. Later we research on it.
But dual disc brakes, which is good. Rear disc brake as well. Fuel injection, which is always welcome. And yeah, pretty much that's it. It's a very simple bike. You don't really get the bells and whistles of the newer bikes, which comes with, you know, like traction control or
heavy. There is heavy on electronics,
Yes. So this bike is very simple. To be honest, the last time I started this bike was last week, and I never had problems starting this.
You don't ride this bike every day,
I used to ride every day until I got a car, which I have to drive around every day. So this has become my secondary vehicle. And has been fantastic. Has not broken down on me yet. Touch wood. Everything is very simple. I only did a few mods like the fog boot, fog meter. I changed my meter as well. Which is not a stock meter. I changed the rear mud guard I got from Japan. And the handlebar is also not stock. It's also made in Japan. Yeah,
so also got the buy-in mirrors also?
Yeah, the buy-in mirrors also bought from Japan.
So for yourself, you bought it in a way whereby it's like, how to say, retro inspired
Yes.
So everything is from Japan?
Yes, this bike is not say very popular, but most of the parts you can find is easier to find in Japan as compared to in Singapore.
Which website do you go to get these parts?
I just go there and buy, and then I just come back.
Oh, you go there
yeah.
and buy?
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool. So you travel a lot to Japan or?
Once a year, except for last year, of course.
Oh, okay. So for yeah. holiday lah?
For holiday and also like...
for work?
No, not for work. Just mainly holiday and just buying my bike.
It's like, sayang, I nak pergi Japan lah. Oh, apa? Nak beli barang motor?
Yeah, it's like that.
For you are seriously?
For this bike, yes.
Okay, we all know that this is a retro-inspired bike. Does it come with a retro-inspired performance also?
Performance? No, this bike is actually... Okay, maybe older bikes are faster. This one comes with a power cut of 180.
Oh,
so that's the most I can go for this bike. Tested in North South Highway.
Then, is it fast on the highway?
It's fast where it needs to be, but at the same time, it's comfortable when it needs to be. So it's unlike Italian bikes where I feel that because previously I also own a Ducati. For that bike and compared to this bike will allow me to do like on the highest gear at a lower speed like 80, 70, 80 and not have problems, whereas when I rode the Ducati, it just make me like want to push. It keeps asking me to push the bike and going faster and going faster. Next day I know I'm doing 158 kg, so don't tell the police. They don't catch me.
Because how to say, it's so comfortable like to ride. Like you don't feel like you're going very fast, is it?
You don't feel for Italian bikes. You normally don't feel that it's going fast unless you're riding a motard. But for Japanese bikes, it's more safe, comfortable, and it doesn't push you to go very fast. It's only. You have to try it to know, to really believe it. Yamaha, Honda, even Kawasaki. Although Kawasaki has a tendency to make you want to go a bit faster, but for Hondas and Yamahas, they're relatively safe.
Let's talk about the handling wise. How is it in traffic or when you want to do a crank course, for example?
Is it heavy?
Depends on the rider. For me, it's okay, but maybe like if I want to go up the car park and do like one round, I'll be slower than, let's say, other riders who ride a more nimble bike. This is not one of those nimble bikes. It's more like just point A, point B, comfortably. Yeah, this is one of them. But in terms of like handling wise, it's okay. It's not say fantastic. It's just there.
Let's talk about your maintenance schedule. Like, how often do you do your maintenance, and how much, and what are the things that you do?
Okay, for maintenance wise, it's like I said, it's a very simple bike. If you've maintained a Super 4, you probably maintain this bike. It's the same. 4 spark plugs, 4 bottles of engine oil, and that's it. I do it every 3,000 to 5,000.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, depending. So it's very simple.
And like, for yourself, which workshop do you go? You think the api shop can do?
Yeah, they can do.
They can do also.
For my older bikes, I would bring to Hua Chin at Bukit Batok. But for this bike, I can bring anywhere. Normally, I would go to Universal, but I did Valkyrians a few months back at Raceworks. Yeah, and it's all good. No shops have had problems with this bike.
So being a PI bike, like you don't get specific parts or something.
Yeah.
Can you find or not?
No. Not say very easy. There's a audit period. I think about a few months or maybe earlier than that. But if you know how to source yourself, you can find it online at a much easier, at a lower price as well. Yeah.
I see. Considering that this is a naked bike, is it very hot on the engine, especially at the traffic light?
If you go like really, really slow, it's very hot. Temperatures can go from 50 all the way up to 110. That's the highest I went. That was going at really low speeds, 30 for a long period of time. It doesn't give any problems. Occasionally the bike would die if it's too hot, but you can still start and you can still go. But that's the only small thing, but it's okay.
That's the only minor setback lah.
Yeah.
Other than that, does this bike, does this engine has any inherent issues?
No issues at all. Like I said, it's a very simple bike, easy to maintain. Other than that, no issues.
Yeah, Honda is known for its reliable engines, bulletproof engines.
Yes.
Power of Jeep is what they expect. So let's talk about riding posture. Is it comfortable for you? Or you reckon you need to lean forward a bit?
You can try sit down for yourself if you want to.
Little,
For me, it's very comfortable. It's more like a sofa kind of feel. Very, you can lean back. You can be aggressive if you want, but then most of the time just relax.
How's the fuel consumption like? How far can you go on a fuel?
How big is the fuel tank?
Fuel tank is only about 14.5 liters. It doesn't look like it, but the tank's actually very small. I can go about 200-220 on a full tank, but yeah, that depends on how I ride as well.
Mm-hmm.
So other than that, consumption is actually okay. You have to understand that it's also an 1100cc bike, so maybe it's a bit higher than what you're used to, like you're mm-hmm. running a smaller bike, but mm-hmm. other than that, not that high as well for a class 2 bike.
Probably because this is a fuel injection, compared if
carburetor,
then probably carburetor will have a higher fuel consumption.
Yes.
Okay, since this is like a rare bike per se,
yes.
Do you get a lot of loops?
All the time, yes.
Do you dress up like, you know, retro inspired or in
the No, I just wear normal t-shirt.
Like this lah.
Yeah, very old, too old already for me.
So in your 2 years ownership, right, what's your best memory so far with your CB 1100?
Best memories, I would have to say, just riding up to Malaysia. I mean, it's been a while since we rode up to Malaysia.
So how far have you ride up?
Not that far, to be honest. Only, I think,
Melaka?
Melaka,
KL?
KL, yes. I remember like within the month I got this bike, I went to KL by myself.
For
work. Okay, for work.
Yeah.
So it only took me about, I think, 3 hours and a half, so I think it's okay.
How was the ride? Is it really fun? Is it comfortable?
Yeah, it's fun, it's comfortable. It's only that because it's naked, you have to understand that the aerodynamics isn't as fantastic as a sports bike. So you as a rider, you will feel the brunt of the wind.
What speed were you cruising?
160.
160?
160.
At 160, does it vibrate or the handling, is it wobbly?
I've come from two Royal Enfields, a single piston, so that one was actually quite bad. The vibration was quite bad when you're doing like 140, actually 120 and above, the vibration for the single piston is actually quite drastic, but because it's an inline 4 engine, so it's actually pretty comfortable.
So who would you recommend the CB 1100 for?
See, I would recommend this bike for those people who, you know, just want a simple bike that requires not that much of a maintenance. And you know, like going from point A to point B comfortably. And if, let's say, you know, you want to talk about maintenance wise, let's say we're going back to maintenance, since it's easy, you know, those people who maybe feel that they want a class 2 bike but they don't want to spend so much money on the maintenance, this bike is one of the best options.
Actually, to be frank with you guys, like, it's very rare to hear a class 2 bike that it's so easy to maintain.
Yes.
Yeah. Class 2 bike.
You know,
very complicated.
This is one thing I like about this kind of bikes, you know, the retro inspired modern street bikes, really easy to maintain. That is the best part.
Yes.
It just reminds me of, I mean, the class 2 Bs that I've rode before, my Vespa, my CB190X, Phantom. Yes. It's just so simple. Engine, spark plug, oil filter, dah.
Yeah.
and then you cannot go wrong with a Honda, sir.
Honda really is problems. I like coming from a lot of bikes. This bike is one of the least problematic. You can ask my friends. They had to endure my previous bikes, all the problems that came with my previous bikes. But this one, so far, for the last 2 years, I have not had any problems at all. Like zero engine problems.
It's very good to hear.
So even the previous owner doesn't say anything about the engine problems or what?
Actually, when I got it, the previous owner didn't ride as much. So when I got the bike, the tires were totally flat. And then when I pumped the tire, there was like the bulge, you know. Yeah, so okay, I know that I bought like maybe like a bike that is not a good condition. So I did everything that I can, but I didn't touch the engine at all. The engine is still the same as
what you bought. So at that point when you bought the bike, what was the mileage?
The mileage was only, I think, about 40,000.
Oh, not too bad.
40,000.
So still not too bad lah. Okay lah.
Not too bad for a 5 year. I bought it in 2018. So this is a 2013 model, so 5 years, 40,000 is actually very low.
Yeah, quite true. My bike 2 years already 63,000.
So in my personal opinion, I don't really fancy the retro inspired classics. For me, I'm much more of an adventure and sport tourer. But it's nice to see that a class 2 bike, you know, it is like what Asri say, easy to maintain, not simple.
I don't mind owning one of these, you know, because I just like simplicity. That is my functionality and simplicity.
It reminds
is
me of what the Honda Shadow.
Yeah,
but you can't get the Shadow anymore.
Oh, yeah. Now it's not in the Shadows already.
Yeah. Any riders want to review that, you can touch us on our social media pages below.
Okay, if you like this video, like and share with your riding kakis, and don't forget to subscribe.
Thank you once again, Asri, for coming out. And you know, even though your friend asked you to come here, you're still, more than willing to share. That is important. Like, I mean, it's nice to know that riders, to tell riders about, this bike exists in Singapore. Mm. And that's it for the vlog, and we will see you next one.